is the total number of the people living together in a particular place sharing each other's cultures, traditions. Population is changing day by day nowadays because people are being more educated and they need more facilities nowadays. So and it's very difficult to live in this time. So for betterment of life, they are having more number of children, which is increasing population now day by day. And environment is surrounding created by total number of biotic and abiotic components, which includes cultural, religion, and social economical aspects. Place in environment of Nepal. Ecosystem is the harmonious relationship between abiotic and biotic components of environment. As you know, this ecosystem of Nepal, just before me, my friend explained you about this. I hope you all understand about ecosystem of Nepal. And ecosystem can be studied in three ways: physical, biological, and socio-economic aspects. Where Nepal's ecosystem is divided in mountain, hill, and torrid ecosystem. As we all know, Indian region lies between 610 meter to 3,800 meter elevations from sea level. It covers 42% of the total land of Nepal, and which includes 39 districts of Nepal. Hill ecosystem can be more studied by three aspects. They are physical, biological, and socioculture. And physical aspects include this climate, temperature, soil type, topography, etc. And so climate. Hill region has subtropical and temperate climate. Where 3 to 15 degree temperature takes place during winter season and 20 to 24 degrees Celsius occur in summer season, which means during winter season we will feel more cold than forest region. And soil type. The soil type of soil of hill region is alluvial and loxodrome soil, which is found in the valley of hills, where sandy rocks and gravelly soil is in gently sloped in hill. Topographic structure. We all know that hill region have highly inclined and elevated one, which means it differs more than torrid and mountain region. Physical aspects. In biological aspects, look here. It contains types of vegetation, trees, herbs, wildlife, domesticated animals, cultivated plants. Biological aspects, especially it includes their cultural tradition and how they live in society. The types of vegetation that we can find in any region is subtropical and temperate forest, with where cottonwood, chilone, pinyo, series are some of the trees it contains, and chiraito, bojo, tezpatra are some of the herbs that we can find there easily. And wildlife, like barking bear, wild boar, wild cats, leopard, eagle, kites, dogs, etc. We can find there, as well as cow, goat, pig are domesticated animals, which helps them in their daily activities to earn money. And cultivated plants, as the region is more inclined and gently slope elevated, it's very difficult to grow different types of paddies and crops. But maize, wheat, rice, potato are some of the crops, cash crops, and food crops that we can find easily for their daily life. Economic aspects. We can find rai, limuche, trinagar, tamang, brahmins, etc. types of different cultures, peoples living there. Where agriculture or culture industries are some of the main economies. Today's total percent of population we can find according to 2011 is 42%. As different types of valleys, and cities we can find like Kathmandu, Bhubaneswar, Dolka, Ohalganga. As Kathmandu is more populated and it is our capital city of Nepal, so we will have more population in there and more development activities will take place. The traces they were that we can find even there is Daura Surwa, Dhaka Topi, Cholo, Parya, etc. Where Hinduism, Buddhism and Islam are main religions of that place, of Ili region, where Manakamana, Pashupatinath, Holisil, Swayambhunath are some of the religious places that Ili region contain. And social facilities. As capital city of Nepal lies in Ili region, it is more highly facilitated. It is highly facilitated. We can have more facilities there. We can have different types of education, social, different types of facilities you can find easily there, and types of houses. The people they are living there are more highly, as they are more facilities. They have buildings, and some of the hills, some of the people they still live in more modern stone houses. Now my next topic is torrid ecosystem and environment. As torrid region lies between 65 meters to 610 elevations from sea level, which is situated in southern part of Nepal, which covers 23% of total land of Nepal and consists of 20 districts. It is torrid region contains more fertile, more populated cities. We can more populated region. Torrid region have tropical climate which includes hot and humid, where 12 to 18 degree temperature we can find during winter and 27 to 30 degree temperature we can find in summer, which means during summer time we will feel more hotter than mountain and hilly region. And the soil type of the torrid region is fertile and arable soil, which means we can grow more crops and earn money and live luxuriously. And topographic is structure. As torrid region is more plain or fertile, its topographic structure is plain, and we can grow more crops. Physical resources, we can find different types of physical resources in torrid region, like river, mainly rivers which comes from here, mountain and torrid region, mountain and hilly region, which finally meet in torrid region. And it is the main vegetation we can find easily in torrid region. And tiger, elephant, rhino, deer, python, peacock, giant fish, hornbills are some of the wildlife that we can find in torrid region, especially in Chitwa National Park and Kosi Reserve. We have many national parks and conservation area where rare animals we can find easily being conserved and protected. And domesticated animals are cow, buffalo and pig. We can find rice, maize, wheat, banana, mango, papaya.